The motto of the Longborough School for Boys was Institutum Superior Omnibus, or Tradition Over All. But on this morning, whether it was the topic of flight or the brandy in the teacher's parlor, Mr. Galt threw tradition to the wind and let the students choose their own lab partners. Young Ned, however, found his chosen for him. Eugene Mulchandani was an exchange student from Gorakhpur, India. Young Ned felt a gnawing pity growing in his stomach, as was tradition. But beneath Eugene's headgear thrived an active imagination and a useful gift for aeronautical model building, as well as the hope that someone might not dislike him for the simple fact that he was different. Young Ned found himself breaking with his own tradition and, in a moment of passion, he fought back. For the first time since his father dropped him off, young Ned made a friend. In the surge of emotion, he forgot his mother had died, his father had left him, and that he missed a girl named Chuck. He also forgot he was jumping into a pile of dead leaves that were once alive. Eugene Mulchandani fled in a flurry of saliva and fear. Eugene would eventually forget young Ned's mistake and chalk it up to magic leaves. But young Ned would never forget that happiness born of passion is always short-lived. At this very moment at the Longborough School for Boys, when it came to the currency of popularity, young Ned was poor, but not the poorest. Eugene Mulchandani's thick accent and unfortunate family history of disproportionate jaw structure made him both extremely difficult to understand and an easy mark for bullies. Young Ned knew that playing with Eugene meant losing his marbles, but he considered the sacrificed Aggies, Steelies, and Shooters an act of charity. For aside from Ned, Eugene had only two other companions, Bilbo, his lethargic Indian python, and Akbar, a bunny. Eugene was devastated when he learned that, upon attempting to eat Akbar the bunny, Bilbo the snake choked, killing them both. Under the guise of burying Eugene's pets, young Ned resolved to perform another act of charity for his language-mangling friend. He knew that giving Eugene his friends back would require two innocent creatures to die. And a lie about how he found them both barely breathing when he went to bury them. But as long as the benefits outweighed the costs, he also believed an act of charity outweighed the consequences. At this moment, young Ned is 9 years, 9 months, 15 days, 10 hours, and 2 minutes old. Awakened by loneliness-induced insomnia, he found himself in desperate need of comfort. And comfort for Ned meant pie. The risks were great, but young Ned rationalized his rogue impulse baking as sheep counting. What harm could come of a single pie in the dark of night with all the evidence ingested? He was caught in flagrante delicto by one Eugene Mulchandani, who immediately joined him in the act. Ned and Eugene were unprepared for what happened next. The aroma of freshly baked pie wafting through boarding school halls awakened an entire class who had but one thing in common. They were all far from home and needed comfort. The longing and homesickness which filled the school like a plague was magically lifted with every bite, and the party began. Thank you. until the party stopped. And young Ned learned that even a forkful of immediate gratification can lead to a world of grave consequences. At this very moment at the Longborough School for Boys, young Ned had convinced Eugene Mulchandani to go to war. For not only was it proof of his undying patriotism, it was also a much-needed escape from an advanced geometry lesson in proofs of the Pythagorean kind. However, like all ill-advised troop deployments, it did not come without its share of unexpected casualties. As they approached their first combat fatality, Eugene's emotional radar was overcome, forcing a hasty retreat. Young Ned, on the other hand, stood his ground. He rationalized that if he solved the hunter's murder, the acclaim would bring his father back into his life. But the hunter revealed his cause of death was accidental and self-inflicted. There was no murderer to be caught, though the park ranger would believe otherwise. Waking the dead had landed young Ned in jail. Both boys were perceived by Papen County Juvenile Correction officers as anything but heroes. And while his comrades secured an honorable discharge through the strength of his parental allies, young Ned realized that his father was not going to fight his battles for him. For in jail, as in life, he needed to take responsibility for his actions.